Is he heads up?
He's okay. He was standing up. He's head up.
Hey, buddy.
Poor brick down there.
Okay.
We're going to get you out, Bentley. It's okay.
What's your name, big guy? Okay, what's his name? Bentley. Okay. It's all right.
Bentley boy. She was just walking around, and I guess he stepped on this thing, and the lid flipped.
Okay. Like this far off.
Okay. We're good. He's Bentley good. He's boy. Upright. He's yep. breathing.
He's doing good.
He's crying, which is a great thing. We're in good shape.
He might have landed on the brick.
Yeah, well, we'll figure all that out when we get out of there.
Do we know what happened?
Just that they were all really strong. And he walked right across this, and it was literally...
It's okay, buddy. He's good with grabbing stuff, so I think once they get a rope down, he should be able to finagle his way in there. He's used to it with his car seat.
Sure.
It's okay, buddy.
You're all right. See, and he's standing up. Well, he's good. He's good. He's standing up. Both of his legs are okay.
He's all right.
He's all right.
He might have got scratched up on
the... Oh, yeah. He's probably good. There's people coming to help. You hear them? You're all right, buddy.
I heard her scream. I was in the...
They have fire on the way?
Yeah,
rescue? Okay.
City building.
I don't have anything in my car. I normally have some rope or something, but I don't. He's fine. He's like 14 feet down, though. He's like 15 feet down. On his feet upright in the hole. He's standing. He appears uninjured at this time. It's going to be a process to get him extricated. If you have any law enforcement running emergent traffic, they can slow down. What's up, buddy? Were they trying to get a hold of me? Do you know? Because none of my radios went off. I don't even think they put this page on the law enforcement active 911. He's fine. He's on his feet down there. It's a long freaking way down, though.
Did he fall down there?
So they were running around. The lid wasn't secured, and it flipped off the hole.
And down he went?
Yeah. He's just big enough.
For him?
For him.
Yeah.
I drove by and I saw her freaking out like she was falling. I was like, what the hell? So I went around and as I pulled in, and it said they had just called you guys.
Yeah.
He's down there.
Yeah.
It was a
fall.
Yeah, that was a fall.
Yeah.
I would assume.
They're made out of rubber.
I would assume. So if he goes out, he slows down. It's just big enough, dude.
Cool. Hopefully he just hold on to the rope and they just yank him out. How old is he?
14 months? 14 months. He needs to put it around and then cross his arms. I don't know if parents can communicate that to him or not.
All right, dispatch called me. 14-month-old stuck in a hole, about 10 feet deep.
Is there a long extendable pole or something?
We have a catch pole. We don't.
Throw a gun belt on or anything.
It'd be all right.
I think it'll be okay.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Yeah, I was going to say.
Good. I was about to say, I got a sawzall literally across the way. I think he's going to be. Let me just grab that.
We got a sawzall on the rescue.
Yeah.
Front or driver's left.
Well, like, take this and butcher whatever you need to.
Longer than that or what, but that's where you started cutting.
I'm willing to, good as idea as any. Whatever one of you fire guys come up with that, you're pretty smart.
Is it glued on there? Do we double check that? Make sure it's not going to...
Thank you.
doing my patrol thing. Yeah.
Is he strong enough to hold him there?
Probably not. He's strong enough to put a rope around him.
I don't think there's a training for this. This is
there is.
Is there?
Yeah. Okay, find space rescue. The reason I asked about a catch pole, you need to get under his shoulders, right? And if you can get a catch pole around his body, tighten it up, it's not going to be comfortable coming up. It's not near as dangerous as this.
That's
what I asked before they put in the fucking hole. Falco, can you use that pole on one side to stretch out a loop on the rope? Does that make sense?
We can loop it over.
Keep, use that to pin the rope to one side.
What's your idea? Hey, run that rope down there.
You want a catch pole, basically?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah,
No.
We'll just make a quick catch pole.
You got that in?
Yeah.
So I'll give that to you.
Hi, buddy.
Hey, Bentley.
Guys, we're going to try to make a catch pole kind of rig here. Make it big enough to manipulate. I fucked that up, didn't I? Yeah.
You're close.
Got like 12 feet. Yeah. Every bit, almost every bit of this.
It's deep. I mean, you're at least 12 feet.
Gonna,
if you can't get that around his shoulders or something, or even take as much slack as you need. Do you need the other side of it supported to where if we tied this yellow line to it?
Give me something else. Is there anything long enough to stick down there to try to help maneuver that rope?
Yeah. What are you guys looking for?
Just an 8 or 10 foot
Jeremy,
stick or something.
Jeremy's wanting to grab another one.
Maybe use the handle end.
Who and what's what?
I don't know. This is mom. Dad is, I believe that's dad's in the gray shirt, and that's brother. So. And this is your guys' house, ma'am. There we go. We got an arm, we got an arm.
All right, Jeremy.
Nice and easy.
All right.
Nice and slack.
Loosen it up, loosen it up here.
Yep.
Let's just go down.
There you go, plenty of slack, plenty of slack. Right here, right here.
Patient is out of the hole. We'll be evaluating the patient now.
What kind of pit is it? What's it for?
I think it's a sump pump.
Sump?
Yep.
Okay. Sump pump?
Sump pump.
You need a light down there?
Where'd my flashlight go, actually? I need to find mine. Some firefighter has it. They'll steal it. I guarantee it. Yep, that's the one. Outstanding. It's just a hole.
Yeah.
Okay. It doesn't look like it.
I don't know. I don't.
Oh, I'm sure it did, but yep.
Have a purpose anymore. Go away like yesterday.
Yeah, because that's how it happened. Yeah. I mean, it's like a freaking booby trap.
Yeah, if it's not in there just right.
Do you know what is it? Is it still using an arc? It doesn't look like there's nothing that comes in. It's just nothing in there. Yeah, I'll make this fair for the
thing. Thank you, sir.
Appreciate it.
Good idea.
Thanks.
Guys, I thank you very much for being here. Yeah. I appreciate it. It's kind of a scary deal.
Yes, sir.
You got something you want to put over it for right now?
Or yeah, we'll
even like a sandbag or something that the kids can't lift. It's just a straight empty hole. Yeah, he was all the way down. We got it around his body, under his shoulders. So, basically made a giant catch pole. Yeah, thank God. Fuck.
Well, he'd have hit his head if he'd have gone head first.
Yeah.
Could have done a lot more damage.
Yep.
We might not have given your 14-year-old son an option then. We'd have just stuffed him.
Oh, he gets so damn wide now.
Oh, sorry.
All right.
I haven't seen you in a while.
Right? Weird, right? No, man, I'm just going to, I'll probably get parents' info and do a short, add it to the email, basically. So I appreciate you guys coming out.
Yeah,
Did you hear me coming over the radio? Did anybody?
I heard you and you kept getting.
Okay.
I think they're just saying they're not listening.
Jesus. Did they dispatch it to me? They dispatched it to you.
Yeah, they dispatched.
I already called us.
Okay.
What time?
I'm not trying to piss people. No, I'm just trying to understand the process.
Yeah. No,
what time did you come out today?
6 a.m.
You know what the process was? Full fucking panic mode. I'm gonna hit the first 6 number I see, and we're just gonna send that.
Yeah. Yeah, I was already on my way. I saw it. They didn't even do the active alert to Moundridge PD. So they did it to EMS. I was on the way here. But then I started hearing. It was weird. Right. Whatever.
I already called. I got it fixed.
Cool. I appreciate you, buddy.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks.
Are they getting ready to take off?
I don't.
Are they still doing an assessment?
What's going on, guys?
I'm gonna get a little tight on your leg.
What's your name, sir?
My name's Blake.
Blake.
Yes, sir. Zordman.
Zordman. Okay. And you?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth Zordman.
Yes.
Okay. Cool. We typed a little information report, basically. So I'm glad he's doing all right.
Mm-hmm.
Why? No, I had it on the back. I
didn't
know clue where it is.
Bentley's
okay.
Bentley.
What?
I was wondering.
Youngster's
name?
Bentley?
Bentley.
Oh, Bentley's
wait,
Zordman?
Absolutely
yep. Okay.
Nuts.
Yeah, we're good.
Where our house and the neighbors is.
I don't hear
fine.
Yeah,
areas.
He's just loving mama up.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yep.
Around. That's why she was whoever.
All right, buddy. I think I'm gonna. Do you guys need anything from me?
No.
All right.
We all good.
Cool. Appreciate it.
Oh, hey, good idea there.
I tried.
Mr. Dogcat, you want to come to dog here today?
No, but I did. I did rig a catch pole for a raccoon in my neighbor's house. It crawled down the chimney while they were on vacation.
Oh,
and had its way with the cereal and shit all over the fucking place. Couldn't get back out.
Pissed.
And was holed up in her closet. So, yeah. It's pretty funny. I appreciate you, buddy.
All right. I literally did nothing.
Well.
They just called me. I'm like,
so good. So, apparently.
That sounds not good.
Yeah. They've never dispatched me to it. The county, I think he was the supervisor. I can't remember his fucking name now.
Willems?
Jake?
Yeah. He already called dispatch and was like, hey, what the fuck? So, they never dispatched me. They were ignoring me on the radio as I was trying to give updates.
Yeah, I heard that.
Like, it was a little irritating.
Oh, yeah. Well, I get they're probably
chaos,
talking to EMS
sure.
And fires.
Well,